Beautiful music to soothe our soul as we enter into this sacred moment of prayer. Brothers and sisters, this is Father Michael, along with the rest of our team. Thank you for joining us in prayer at the God Minute. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
O Lord, open my lips.
And my mouth shall declare your praise.
Psalm 9. You amaze me. You amaze me, O God. Your many wonderful gifts fill me. Until I am so high that my joy spills out in song, and I overflow with thanksgiving and praise.
I don't know why, but you love me. You tell me the truth about me and speak to my heart of how things should be. You draw me back from my confusion. You help me and care for me.
You let me know the wrongs I've done. Let me feel the pain. Then you forgive me, soothe and heal me, trusting in my better self.
You amaze me, God. How arrogant we must seem, how small in defying you. Bring us into your presence. Show us who we are, as you made us to be.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
A reading from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 5, verses 17 to 18. And Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not think that I have come to abolish the law or the prophets. I have come not to abolish, but to fulfill." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Do you recall the last time you wanted something in your life to end? Perhaps you felt tired, or maybe you were ready for a change and needed to transition to something different and new. Of course, there are times when the new we seek is to avoid something and to move on without having to deal with what needs to happen. We can tell ourselves that we are ready to move on, when in fact, we are not ready, and we need to confront the situation. I think these two attitudes are at play in today's reading. Jesus tells his disciples and us that he has come not to abolish the law or the prophets. So if we are looking for an easy way out, good luck. It's not going to happen. Far from it. Avoidance, denial, and escape are not options. Following Jesus can never be a matter of low standards. It's helpful to recall that today's words come after the Sermon on the Mount. Jesus has been sharing the virtues that are expected of all of us. We must seek poverty of spirit, mercy, peace, courage. We must thirst and hunger for righteousness. Far from abolishing these virtuous standards, Jesus rather encourages us to set our eyes on what is truly life-giving, to be peacemakers, to practice mercy, to be courageous when things are not easy, to be ready to transform ourselves and the world. As followers of Jesus, we are called to go out into the existential peripheries, to encounter one another with the grace and the truth of the Spirit. In Jesus, we are the salt of the earth and the light of the world. As such, no one lights a lamp to put it under a tub. They put it on the lampstand, where it shines for everyone. Living this reality means commitment. Being salt and light for others gives renewed direction and purpose to the law and the prophets. How will you embrace this prophetic mission? How will Jesus' confidence in you and me find new directions? May our prayer today be a source of strength and motivation to take the necessary steps for the transformation that awaits us in Christ Jesus.
As we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ, we pray as he taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, from whom all good things come, grant that we who call on you in our need may at your prompting discern what is right and just and holy and true, and by your guidance do it. This we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Beloved of God, thanks so much for joining us in prayer today. It's always a great privilege to be able to share this moment of God's grace with you. Do take good care of yourself and one another, and we'll see you tomorrow.